Hey, Sintra, thanks so much for joining us once again for Wellbeing at Sintra. This is a new series that we're going to follow through the year. And really what our intent is to educate you about well-being, what it means to be a well-being. And so for this second episode, last week we introduced you to our wellness program for 2020, our incentive program. This week, we just want to talk about the tenets and the basics about well-being. There are a lot of misconceptions about well-being. Oftentimes, we think that well-being means, at least for me, I think about being physically fit or my health. Am I healthy? If I'm healthy, then I'm well. Or we think about maybe being happy. Am I really happy? And of course, both of those are tenets of well-being, but well-being is a little bit more than that. Aubrey, tell us really what it means when we say when we use the term well-being.
I think that's a very interesting question because over time, I believe in the wellness space, you've seen this progression of, you know, typically we are very concerned about our people's physical health and how things are going from a perspective of disease states. That's always been really important for people. But over the years, as I've been in this industry, I've seen it just continue to grow and expand and widen because I think the research is just everywhere showing, hey, when we're completely well, that entails a lot more things than just your physical health, even just your mental health or the nutrition that you take in. But it really covers a vast majority of the things that you do day in and day out. So how you feel at work when you're coming in, or do you feel like you can make it through the day, both in emotionally speaking, but also physically? How do you feel when you go in? Do you feel like you're thriving when you're at work? How about when you go home? Do you have the energy to sustain that evening, whether you have children or maybe it's just you and a spouse, or maybe it's your individual self trying to take care of things around the house? Like, how much energy are you able to take back with you into that space? And so I think it's just become a lot bigger and it's expanding. And what we want to do at Sintra is make sure that we are keeping up with what the research is telling us, and that we are finding ways to help you really engage in a holistic view of well-being.
I like the word holistic, and I think that in the past we've looked at our lives in segments. We've kind of compartmentalized everything where this is my life at work, and this is my life at home, and this is my life within community, and that all these things are separate, when in reality it makes up all of who we are. And so holistic is such a great word. I also love the word that you use, thriving. And it's about how those different pieces interact with one another. Yeah. And are we thriving in all areas of our life? So we could be really thriving here in a professional setting, but just not thriving at home, or vice versa. Mm-hmm. And we bring those things into the different spaces. And so at Sintra, we're just really concerned, and in a good way, about having well caregivers in all aspects of life. And so that is one of the things that we've set out to educate on this year, and also to provide initiatives, like we talked about the wellness program, to provide initiatives for our caregivers through this year. So as we close, next week we're going to talk about different tenets of well-being, but Gallup did some research at over 98 different countries, as a matter of fact, and they talked with people about the different aspects of their lives that they felt like were most important to their thriving, to their happiness. And Aubrey, tell us what those five tenets are, and then of course next week we'll dive deeper.
Yeah, so we're really excited about these five tenets because, as we've talked about, we really want to be thriving individuals. I don't know about you, but I like to feel energized at work and at home on the weekends. Whatever I'm doing, right, is a good feeling. Right. And so these five areas, of course, include physical health. We want to make sure that we're taken care of physically, mentally, all of those ways. But it also includes our social well-being, our community well-being, and then, of course, career and our professional well-being. How are we doing in that workspace?
Great. So as we discussed, it's not just one thing and they're not segmented. It's how they interact. It's a holistic view. And so that just kind of gives you a good foundation about well-being. And so we appreciate you tuning in today. We hope that you'll tune in next week as we discuss a little bit about each of those tenets. And we hope you have a well week. Have a good one, Central. We'll see you soon.